Hey, welcome back to Serve Neat. This is episode 2. Today we're going to be talking about rums.
So rum is perhaps one of the more popular spirits, especially historically, because sugar was a big crop back in the day, so a lot of byproducts like molasses, which they make rum from. Rum falls into mostly four categories.
We have the clear one.
White silver. Mostly not a lot of flavor, just a little bit of sugar coating.
Right. And it's most of the time a lot stronger than the other ones. The second one is going to be your amber one, which is the spice rum.
Amber or spice.
Right. Oh.
All amber rum is aged in barrels and turns amber. So sometimes they take that, bottle it, serve it, or mix it with different kinds to make a tasting profile.
Then we have dark rums.
Which are made in the same barrels, but they char the barrels first.
And then we also have a navy rum, which most people don't drink. And then a black rum.
Like a black spice rum, which is like the Kraken, which is one of our favorite rums.
Yes. Hijo is going to be the first one we'll try. All right, and it's from France. Hijo is from France, and it's going to have honey, ginger, candy flavor, and something that I absolutely despise, licorice.
So I think the licorice and the ginger are going to set this apart as a French spice rum. Yes. A lot of the Caribbean spice rums mostly rely on the candy, caramel, cinnamon type situation. So, what does it smell like?
It smells a little bit like ginger. I can smell the ginger.
It has like absolutely no legs on it. It does not stand up at all.
This smells really sweet. So the candy, I can smell the candy.
It's very alcohol forward. Like you can smell it
right
coming off it.
Are you ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's try it.
Cheers.
Cheers.
It tastes like drinking alcoholic honey. Like if
no, it's licorice in it. Oh
I
my!
Have no licorice flavor. I am thinking like the B movie mixed with like pub trivia. This tastes like alcoholic honey.
No,
like this is what bees drink
like
drunk.
Hot damn! I remember being in Germany and having the licorice, and it tastes just like I'm not a big fan of it. I'm just gonna tell you right now. I'm gonna give it a 1 because I will not buy this again. Well, I'm gonna try this to finish off the glass, but that's gonna be it for me.
That's ever. The end.
Ever.
It's not my favorite thing in the world. I don't mind it. It does taste like alcoholic honeycomb. It's not my favorite thing in the world, and I would not purchase this. It's a straight 1.
1 across the board.
Alright, so our second spice rum is going to be
Sailor Jerry.
This is overproofed a bit. This is 92 proof, so it's over 40% alcohol.
I'm gonna have a bite. Nothing less smell to it. Sugary smell, of course.
Bold and smooth as hell is its tagline.
You can smell the alcohol in it.
Yes, the first flavor note of the nose is grain alcohol. Or not grain alcohol, cane alcohol, I guess would be the point. It's very much ethanol forward.
It almost smells like...
It definitely has a...
...nail polish remover.
Bit, probably because it doesn't taste like... Give it a shot.
Let's give it a shot.
Cheers.
Cheers. Ooh. Strong vanilla flavor.
Vanilla caramel, straight up. This tastes like ice cream.
And you know what? It doesn't have a bite of alcohol as much as I thought with the smell to it. And I tried it before and I never really thought about it. Because sometimes you just drink different things to drink it. So when you take a second to sit back and smell it and taste the flavor, you really smell and taste different things that you never tasted before.
And this is delicious. I mean, to be honest, spice rum is not something you ever gonna drink neat, for the most part.
No.
It's a great mixing. And I mean, you've got a lot of notes in here. You've got caramel, you've got cinnamon a little bit.
Right, the vanilla.
Definitely have a strong vanilla flavor. This tastes like, I don't know if you ever were a kid and you ever smelled vanilla extract and you thought this is going to be amazing and you tried it and it ruined your life because vanilla extract is not good. This tastes like what vanilla extract should taste like.
Right. I think this is becoming more popular than it was, or I don't know how to. It's not as popular as I think it should be compared to the other brands that are out there, but it's, I'm telling you, it's fantastic. And it's not that expensive either.
Okay, so we can just say there's a brand of the pirate that holds its leg up on a cask. That's the most popular one.
Right. I think this tastes better than
this. Has a bit more flavor and a bit nicer than Old Mr. Morgan. Alright, so we're gonna do two amber rums. Now we're gonna start with one from
Guatemala.
It is Ron Zacapa XO. And it is an amber rum. It has what they say notes of chocolate, tobacco.
Right.
What else?
Ooh. We're gonna find out.
The color is amazing.
It's just. And if you look online, people give this a very, very high review. It's not a cheap rum, I'm gonna be honest with you. It's not out of like a crazy amount. But it's
retail
not cheap.
For bottle?
$120 for.
Not something you're gonna have for a house party.
No.
But something you could have for yourself.
Right. Or.
So the amber rums are usually aged for these kind of reasons to make sure that the flavor and stuff is right so you can drink them more.
You gonna try it?
Yeah.
Now I'll be honest, I think this literally is the smoothest rum I've ever tried.
I'm gonna be honest and say he's a liar. No, I have no idea. It is delicious.
It is delicious. It really is.
I'm not a rum fan. I don't drink rum if I'm out in a social setting. I don't really keep rum in my own personal home bar, except for maybe a bottle of Bacardi or something generic.
Right. And most of the time when you do drink rum, again, like you said before, it's going to be like rum and coke, or it's going to get mixed with into something else.
It doesn't need a mixer.
It doesn't. It doesn't need a mixer. So if you want to chill out at your house and relax and just drink some.
By the pool? Because rum just seems like the outside drink.
You need some palm trees too. But it's fantastic, and I'm gonna drink some more and then rate it.
I'm gonna give it a 4. I probably won't buy it. I don't really have a reason to have it in my home personal bar.
That's good. So
wait, that's a 4.
4.
So I'll give it a 3.
If
you know what?
Price wasn't. A,
you know what?
If you're talking about price.
We're going for a 3.
I'm gonna take it a 4 because I would love to continue drinking this. So my verdict is a 4.
Alright, the last one is a special one.
It's very special, and I didn't know that this person.
Don't spoil it. This is Ron De Jeremy. Not Ron De Jeremy, it's Ron De Jeremy. Yes. Some adults around you, if they know of Mr. Jeremy's film career.
I'm just, hopefully it's not salty.
This is a rum that is marketed by Ron Jeremy. It's an amber rum. It's been aged. You can tell by the color, it's got a nice barrel age to it.
And it has flavors of oak, vanilla, and cherry. So, let's try
Ron
that.
Jeremy and cherries. There's a joke there somewhere.
Maybe.
It does have a cherry-esque color. Esque.
It's very dark, and it is a dark rum. It's not a spice rum.
Retail?
Retail price is $41 per bottle.
So this is almost comparable to Bacardi-ish. Bacardi is a little cheaper, but I mean, this is supposed to be more quality. And it does have some time spent in barrels, so there is a little more work.
And he does have cheaper rums.
Oh,
he has different tears.
I'm sorry, I don't want to talk to you. I'm sorry to interrupt. That is delicious. Smell that.
Is it? Ooh, it does smell very good.
I don't know if it smells like Ron Jeremy, or smells like Ron Jeremy, or smells like cherries, pardon me, but it is delicious.
Like sweet cherries and rum.
Alright, so.
Cheers.
Cheers. Save your $8 and buy the Ron De Jeremy. The Ron De Jeremy is better than Ron Zacapa.
It's sweeter.
It's not even sweeter.
It is
sweeter, but it's a bit milder in a weird way. But now that I'm sitting here on it, it has a weird aftertaste.
Yeah, it does. list.
I'm reviewing my review and saying it was wrong.
I would go, out of all of them, if price was no issue, I would go with Ron Sakafa. Now, if...
You only got $50 and you only buy the best, you can get
I'm
$50.
I'm going to pick the sale of Jerry.
I'd go with the sale of Jerry, too.
I think you get the most bang for the buck on that one.
Ron and Jerry make great incense. Smells good.
It's not bad though.
I mean, it's not the worst thing. It has a weird aftertaste.
I would definitely drink it to somebody.
What's that taste? That's that taste that hits you in the back of the throat.
It is.
Makes you feel some kind of way after you drink it. Does it feel like shame?
It kind of does.
There's a flavor I don't care for at the end.
Wow.
It's a one. Because it tastes like hydrogen peroxide at the end, and it leaves a bad taste in the back of my throat. And I cannot tell people that the Ron Jeremy Ron left a taste in the back of my throat.
Bad taste in the back of the throat. I don't have a problem with it.
This is going to be terrible, but maybe it has a flavor that complements Roofies. I don't know, but there's something terrible.
Have you tried Roofies before?
I don't, neither have I, but Ron Jeremy's slander. I'm just going to say I don't like it. It's a one at the end.
I'm going to give it a...
I was excited for this one.
Two. I'm gonna give it two. I'll drink it if somebody buys it for me. I can't even make jokes right now.
Would you think it would have more staying power?
I would think it had a little bit more thrust in its.
A little more stamina?
And a little bit more stamina in its strength.
Instead, it's a little hairy and skeezy. Alright, we're gonna
cocktail.
Alright, so for the last thing we're gonna do on this rum centric episode, we're going to make some cocktails. The most classic cocktail for any rum is going to be a daiquiri. This is a little bit of a switched up daiquiri. Technically, daiquiris are straight white or silver rum, simple syrup or sugar, water,
and
or lime juice.
We're using spice rum.
We are, and lime juice and simple syrup. So we're really not switching up the recipe too bad, because it's 2 points. This was Ernest Hemingway's favorite drink, the lime daiquiri. You can serve these on the rocks. I prefer to shake them until when I started making this cocktail, this was full of ice, and I've shaken it down to here. So I've actually added a bit more water to it.
Right.
Because straight lime juice is pretty abrasive.
Anyway.
Ooh. That's perfect. That's summer. The recipe for this was equal parts lime juice and sugar water to make basically limeade. And then we poured about 1.5 parts of spice rum on top.
Right.
So I think that's it for
thank you. Thank you for joining us today. And don't forget to subscribe. Give us a like.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. And remember, always serve it neat.